This is the southern end of the City of Rocks National Reserve in southern Idaho. This area, its most namesake feature is called Twin Sisters, and you can just see that little pinnacle sticking up above the hill over there. I believe that's the South Sister. The Twin Sisters are out of view mostly, but are this prominent sort of double monoliths of granitic rock, and they formed a major a landmark to immigrants heading west on the California Trail in the mid to late 1800s. What makes this area special is City of Rocks, of course, is dominated by granitic rock that has been sculpted and shaped into a really fascinating landscape of towers and fins and arches and pinnacles and all sorts of things. But I'm particularly fascinated and interested today in looking at the rocks themselves and what they have to tell us about this area. So the face behind me here is one of the more spectacular outcrops in the area, and yet there's no tourists here, there's no trail here, and yet it's not very far from the Twin Sisters, maybe like I said, a half mile or so to the east. But when we look at this, we can see there's two distinct colors of rock. You have kind of the brownish rock, the darker rock there, and then you have the white rock sort of cutting through it in random arrangements. And as we wheel around towards the east, you can kind of see that pattern continue. Lots of white stripes and splashes and all sorts of different shapes in the rock there. What we're seeing here is the contact between the granite that makes up most of the City of Rocks area, which is a very young granite. It's actually the youngest granite in Idaho. It's 28 million years old, from the Oligocene epoch. And that granite is the white granite we see here, the very light colored stuff. Well, we're gonna go take a closer look at it here in a second. The darker colored material is some of the oldest rocks in Western North America. This rock is 2.5 billion years old. So this is 2.5 billion year old granite. So we have two types of granites here, but you can see a difference in color. And we're gonna go look at these closer, and so you can see some of the differences, not just in color, but mineralogy, texture, that sort of thing. So what's happened here, well, we have this great viewpoint, is these older granites had been here for obviously billions of years. And then 28 million years ago, magma intruded this region, and that magma started forcing its way through fractures and cracks. You can imagine being 2.5 billion years old, this old granite had a lot of fractures and cracks, and it had been pretty weathered over time. Of course, this is all happening underground, but the magma, the young 28 million year old magma, worked its way through those cracks to form these big white stripes you see here. So there's places where there's disconnected pieces of the older granite, like we see down here. And we have all these dikes, all these intrusions of magma cutting through it. So this is just one of the better outcrops, I think, for sort of seeing the relationships there. So we have this younger granite or magma intruding into this older granite here. I'm actually standing on some of the older granite down here. And this is probably as good a place as any at looking at its sort of textural features here. So if we kind of get in close here, you can see that it's overall kind of weathering to this reddish brown color. That's mainly iron oxidation. But the most conspicuous thing about this older Archean granite are these large, in some cases they're, you know, as big as your thumb, rectangular often, crystals of potassium feldspar. So these are big crystals. We sometimes call this type of texture megacristic, meaning it has very large crystals. So this is very indicative and characteristic of this older Archean granite, are these very large feldspar crystals that sort of stick out and weather out in relief. Here's one right by my finger here that's really remarkable, kind of a square, almost a rectangle there. So you can kind of see that along this little spot here. And if we jump over this gap here, here we go. What we can see here is a large rock sticking out of the granite that's dominated by a shiny mica. This is biotite mica. And what this block of rock is a piece of schist. So this is actually a metamorphic rock that formed before the granite. So this is actually older than this 2.5 billion year old granite. And as that magma came up, this piece of rock was then kind of carried with the magma And as the magma cooled around it to form the granite, this remained intact because it's a metamorphic rock that's used to high temperatures and pressures. And so this foreign rock body inside our granite is what we call a xenolith, just a rock embedded inside of another one. And we can see again some of these big crystals here. So we're gonna try to scramble down off of this thing and go look at the contact or the relationships between this older Archean granite, 2.5 billion years old, and this much younger granite, about 28 million years old. So we'll kind of work our way down this thing, try not to fall on camera. That's always good. And there's been a big fire that's obviously burned through here some point in the past. Oh, wow, this is great here. So what we can see here is a great relationship. We can see the older granite. There's those big feldspar crystals again, embedded in the rock. Then a nice sharp contact here. And then this much more fine-grained granite. This is the younger granite. This is the 28 million year old Almo Pluton, or the main part, the main granite that makes up most of the rocks we see at City of Rocks, right in contact with the older Archean granite. Let's see what else we can see here. So that's kind of cutting across it, forming a bit of a, I guess we would call a dike. Well, this looks a little spicy. Not too bad. But let's head over to the outcrop where we can also see some great relationships. Again, very similar to what we saw in the little rock there. But you can see some of the big crystals of the Archean granite in contact with the more fine-grained younger granite. So really quite remarkable, looking at these cool relationships and imagining this magma 28 million years ago injecting itself into what was once magma, and then just all sort of the textures and features you see there. So one of my favorite places here out at Twin Sisters, at the City of Rocks in South Central Idaho.